Hello and welcome to Craft with Sarah. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use my free and paid layered cutting files in Silhouette Studio. So if you have a Silhouette cutting machine, this is how you can use my files. The first thing you'll need to do is download the Silhouette Studio software. And if you've been using your machine for a while, then you'll already have this on your computer. Now, Silhouette Studio comes in a couple of different versions. If you just download it from the website for free, then you've got what's called the Basic Edition, which is the free edition of Silhouette Studio. And that's the version I'm going to be showing how to use in this video. You can also choose to upgrade to one of three paid versions. If you've got the paid version of Silhouette Studio, then you can use the SVG files from my website. So when you go to open the file, make sure you choose the one which starts SVG in the file name. And those will open better than the other files and they'll be easier for you to work with. However, if you'd prefer to keep working with the free basic edition of Silhouette Studio, that's absolutely fine and that's what this video is all about. So I'm going to head over to Silhouette Studio and show you how to load the Dxf version of my layered cutting files. Here is Silhouette Studio, and the first thing to do is download the files, either the free files from my website craftwithsarah.com or any of my paid files which are available at shop.craftwithsarah.com. After downloading the file, the first thing you'll need to do is unzip the download folder that it comes in. This varies a little bit based on what type of computer or device you're using, but for a Windows computer, you just right-click on the folder and press Extract All, and then choose where to save it on your computer. If you check the description of this video, I've put some links in there to written tutorials which go through how to unzip folders in more detail. I'm going to assume I've already unzipped that folder, so let's open the DXF file. Go into File at the top, and then Open, and then choose your unzipped folder, and you need the file which starts DXF in the file name. These are the files that Silhouette Studio Basic Edition, so that free version, these are the files that this can open. So make sure you choose the one which starts DXF. And then that will go ahead and load. And sometimes it can take quite a long time to load. And my top tip is just after you've tried to open it, just when you've got that loading screen, don't touch anything, just leave it to open. It might take a couple of minutes, but just leave your computer alone. If you try to click things or go to other programs whilst it's loading, you might find that Silhouette Studio crashes and then you'll have to close it and try and load it all again. Now, one thing I'm going to say at this point, which I probably should have said at the beginning, is that I actually do not own a Silhouette cutting machine. I've got a Cricut machine. I've done the research for you on how to convert my layered cutting files within Silhouette Studio so that you can cut them. But of course, because I don't actually have the machine, I can't follow it all the way through and actually cut it out and test it. So, please take these instructions with a little bit of a grain of salt. Obviously, you know your machine better than I know a machine that I don't own. However, I am fairly confident that these are the correct steps. If they're not, and if anything in this video is wrong, please leave me a comment below and tell me, and I can make an updated version. Alright, so this is what the DXF file will look like when it's loaded in, and I've chosen to do my layered pumpkin truck. All of the different shapes are available on the screen separately, and they should just look like this little outline with no colour. Now the problem is, this is going to cut really, really small. This whole selection of everything is just over 10 inches tall, which means if you think about it, my poor little layered truck is only going to be, what, 2 inches tall? And that's going to be too small to cut effectively and definitely too small to stick together, particularly on my more intricate designs. This one's actually a fairly simple one, but most of my layered designs have much smaller details in them. We're going to need to make this a lot bigger. But the problem is, if we were just to make this bigger by dragging, it's going to go over the edge of your mat. And also, we don't want to cut all this in the same colour, so we're going to need to split out the different layers into each colour that they're going to be. To start, right-click on the design and press Release Compound Path. This breaks up all of the little pieces, so if I zoom in with the little zoom button on the top, you can now see if I click on something, rather than selecting everything, it just selects that one shape that I've filled. Just going to undo that to put it back into position, because what you'll notice happened is that it didn't select all those little pieces inside, just the outside. We need to tell our silhouette machine that we want it to do these cuts inside the truck at the same time. So to do that, I'm going to scroll to the top so that I can start at the beginning. This one doesn't have anything inside, so that one's fine to be left as is. For this next one, it's got the little circle and the bits in the window. So I'm going to click and drag a box around just this part of the truck, and then right click and group. Now, all of those bits move together when I click away. So now it will know that I want those cuts to always appear inside this silhouette of the truck. So now it knows that I always want these cutouts to appear inside this outline of the truck. And you'll need to do this for every single piece. So there's that one, right click and group. And then this one, you could also, I believe, right click and make compound path, and it should do the same thing. So I'm scrolling down and I just need to do all of these. So a message to all you silhouette users out there, is there a preference about whether you should group them or make compound path? Which one works better? Please let me know. I'm just doing these as compound path. Those I'm going to do together because they'll be cut from the same color, and the same thing with those. And then my pumpkins, these are all fine to be left separate because they'll be cut from different colors. Okay, so now I've done all of these. So now when I pick up any of these layers, you see it's got all the middle bits inside. Now we need to work on the size of the truck. So let's zoom out with the little arrow at the top. Click on the very bottom layer of whatever design you're using. So that'll be the biggest layer that's got the most filled in. Right click and press duplicate, and then move that copy over to the edge. Drag a box around everything else on the screen, right click, and then group. With the one that you copied over here, this is the one we're going to use to size with. So click on it and then change your width and height boxes. I'm going to make mine 9 inches wide. We can then click on our group over here, and I'm going to move this over. I'll need to zoom out a bit more, and then use the little arrows in the corners to drag this big group until that top layer is the same size as the one we've just resized. And the reason we're doing this is because it's going to change all the other layers in proportion at the same time. So we know that everything will still be lined up and will still work and be stuck together correctly. Okay, so that's pretty much spot on now. You see they line up almost exactly. So that means I can then click on that one that we copied and delete it. And now I've got all of my layers and they're correctly sized, ready to go in my shadow box. But they won't all fit on the screen at the moment, and we've still got the problem that they would all be cut from the same color. Right click on the group and then press ungroup again. And we're going to color each of these so we know what we're going to be cutting it out from, and that will make it easier for the next step. To find out what color everything should be, go back to your download folder and open the file called assemblyguide.pdf. This is a printable guide I include with all of my layered files, and it shows you the order in which to stick the layers and also the color that each one should be cut from. So I'm going to use this as a guide to color the graphics in Silhouette Studio. Our bottom layer is going to be a gray, and if you look, the wheels are also that same color. So let's head back to Silhouette Studio and then click that bottom layer. Click the color palette over on the right hand side and then choose a gray. And then for the wheels, I'm going to use this color picker to make sure it's the same gray. And I might even just move them up next to it for now. The next layer will be black, so I'll click it and then color it black. And don't worry if some of your cut lines disappear. I think it should still cut them. It's just you can't see it because it's filled them in. They are still there. If you make it a slightly light color, so a dark gray maybe, instead of a black, you can see that those lines are still there. This one will be a light red, So let's fill that one in. And then these two will be that same color. So let's color pick it into there. The front of the truck will be a darker red. And now I have the pumpkin layers. So this one will be a fairly light green. The next one is yellow. And the final one is orange. Scrolling down, this is the wood on the side of the truck, so that needs to be brown. And then I have the coloured pumpkins on top, which is going to be a darker version of each of these colours. This is the yellow one, so let's go a darker yellow. This one is the orange, and then this one is the green. So these are all slightly darker than the originals. Next, we're going to move everything off of the edge and also put together things that are the same colour. So you see I've put those two together. The grey I'm going to put on my mat because that's what will be cut first. But everything else I'm just putting around the edge. And then those three. Once you get to this point, I would save your file because you don't want to have to do all of this work again if you decide to cut the same file in the future. So file, save as, and then save to hard drive, and then you'll save it as a studio file. This is now ready to start sending to the cutting machine. Now this is the little part that I'm not 100% sure on because as I said, I don't actually have a silhouette machine. But I believe what you'll need to do is go through each color individually, make sure it's on your mat, and then press send at the top. And then that will just send these to your silhouette machine. So when you cut it out, it will just cut out these bits, which you'll do from a grey. When it's finished, you'll need to come back to this screen and then either move the grey bits off of the edge, or you could delete them so that you don't accidentally cut them again. And then move on the next colour onto the mat and do the same process again to get it cut out, only this time you'll use that different colour of card. You'll need to repeat that for every single colour. I hope this video was helpful to show you how to use DXF layered files on the free basic edition version of Silhouette Studio. As I said, I have been kind of putting this video together without ever having actually used a silhouette machine, so if any part of it is wrong, please do leave me a comment. To get all of my free files, go to craftwithsarah.com/free-svgs. Thank you for watching and please subscribe if you enjoyed this video.